Hello, it's Missy. Thank you so much for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share what I would consider some really easy hairstyles for summer, something you could quickly throw your hair into if you wanted to dress it up a little bit. So let me know in the comments whether or not you think these hairstyles are actually easy or on the more complicated side, and also which one is your favorite. I love knowing which one is the favorite. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, make sure to do that and click the notification bell, and then you'll never miss any future videos. And let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to be doing a half-up style, so I'm going to first divide off the section of hair that I'll be using. So from about my ears towards the back of my head, I'm going to tie this off using a clear elastic band. I'm going to create a little bun, so when I'm ready to wrap the elastic the last time, I'm going to pull the hair partway through and create a loop. Then to add some texture to the style, I'm going to pull on small sections of the bun in opposite directions, and I'm also going to pull on small sections of hair around the crown of my head. This will just add some volume and dimension to the hairstyle. And now I'm going to take a small section of hair from the ends, sticking out from the bun, and wrap this around the elastic band. And then I'm going to tuck this piece of hair around the elastic band underneath the bun. This will hold it in place and hide it at the same time. I love this style because I think it's a really cool way to pull your hair back while easily upgrading a more basic half-up style. So for the next hairstyle, I'm going to be doing a high messy bun, and I want to try and keep my part for this style. So I'm going to divide off some hair to frame my face first, and then I'm going to brush the rest of the hair up to the crown of my head. I'm going to take my hairband and wrap it over the hair, and when I do the last wrap of the hairband, I'm going to pull the hair partway through to form a small loop with the hair. Now I'm going to take the rest of the hair that's hanging down from this loop, and I'm going to divide it into two equal sections. I'm going to cross them underneath the bun, then bring each one around to the front of the bun and cross them again. And then I'm going to wrap them a final time back down to the bottom of the bun. And once they're at the bottom again, I'm going to reach underneath the hair and find the hair band. Then I'm going to tuck both sections of hair so they're going around the hair band, and this will hold them in place so the bun doesn't fall out. Once that's done, I'm going to go back over the bun and kind of style it. So to tighten the bun, I'm going to pull on that initial loop in the middle. And then to make the wrap sections bigger, I'm just going to gently pull on small sections to make them come out of the elastic slightly. And the more I pull on sections, the bigger the bun will get. I did have one small section hanging out the back, but I just grabbed a bobby pin and pinned this down. This is a new style of messy bun for me, but I love the way it looks, and I feel like it's an easier technique that really anyone could master. For the next style, I'm going to begin by gathering all of my hair together at the nape of my neck. Then, holding my hairband in my left hand, I'm going to place my right hand upside down and wrap my hair around my pointer finger. So I'm going to grip my hair with my pointer finger and thumb, and then I'm going to twist my hand upwards, and this will pull my hair into a twist as well. And I just want to make sure to keep the hair tight and push the loop at the top against my head so it doesn't fall out. And then I'm going to hold the twist in place with my left hand, so I've got my thumb holding the bottom section with the other fingers holding the top. And I'm going to use a hair fork to hold this in place. So holding the hair fork upside down horizontally, I'm going to place the ends into the twist, pointing towards the left side. And then I'm going to push the top towards the left so the ends catch in the hair. And then I'm going to push into the hair towards the right side. And I did try this style a couple of times to see if I could get it easily. And I did, even though it looked slightly different each time. This is a really super quick way to get your hair off of your neck, making it a perfect style for summer. Today's video is sponsored by Function of Beauty, so I wanted to quickly share how I would use their products to prep my hair for these different hairstyles. The first step in this whole process is washing and conditioning my hair. One of my goals for 2021 is to strengthen my hair. So depending on your hair type and your specific hair goals, you'll want to use a certain type of shampoo and conditioner. Since this can be tricky to figure out, Function of Beauty actually makes this really simple. You may have already heard of them. I've been using them for about 6 months and have noticed a huge difference in the overall quality of my hair. They offer a unique formula of shampoo and conditioner for your specific hair type, and they have a really quick hair quiz to find out details about your hair so you can receive these customized products that work specifically for you. And since I knew what I wanted for my hair, it was really easy to complete. Function of Beauty's products are also vegan and cruelty-free as well, which is something that's very important to me when it comes to shampoo and conditioner. So if you want to receive 20% off your very first order, I will leave a link down below in the description box and you can receive your very own customized products as well. For the next half-up style, I'm going to begin by dividing off the section of hair that I'll be using for my style. I'm going to divide this hair into three smaller pieces. And to make this style more unique, I'm going to make the middle section really small and the other two sections about the same size. And I'm just going to braid the hair into a regular three-strand braid. So I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left strand and the right strand. So I'm just crossing the left strand over the middle, then crossing the right strand over the middle, and then crossing the left strand over the middle again. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, continuing the braid down this section of hair. And I'm only going to go about halfway down the section. You can go all the way to the bottom if you want to, but then I'm going to take a hair elastic and tie off the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And once that's tied off, I'm going to go back over the braid and find the larger sections of hair that I was holding initially, and I'm going to carefully pull these out from the braid. This will make them a lot bigger, so they'll show up a lot better. And since we had one section of hair that was really tiny, this will help make the braid look a little bit offset from a regular style braid, giving it more of a unique look. And this is just another fun and easy way to tie your hair back, making it a little bit more unique than your typical half-up style. For the last hairstyle, I'm going to begin by combining all of my hair at the nape of my neck. Then using a hairband, I'm going to wrap this over my hair. And then on the last wrap of the band, I'm going to create a loop by only pulling my hair partway through. I want this to look a little more casual, so I'm going to go back over the bun and pull on small sections of hair in opposite directions. This will give the bun a more textured and messy look. And then with the ends hanging out the bottom, I'm going to combine these together, and I'm going to wrap them over the top of the bun towards the right side. Then I'm going to find a section of the hairband and tuck this hair around the hairband. This will hold the hair in place while also hiding the elastic and form the top portion of the bun. And since I want this look to be a little more casual, I'm going to pull on small sections of hair around my crown just to add a little bit of volume and dimension. You can leave the ends down to hang out from the bun for a more casual look. If your hair is really long, then you can always loop them another time or pin them up. I liked mine hanging down, but I wanted them to be a little bit shorter, so I just grabbed a bobby pin and pinned them against the right side of the bun just to shorten them a tiny bit. I love low buns in the summer. I think they're really easy to do and they keep your hair off of your neck, and they always tend to look a little bit more dressy. That wraps up today's video. Let me know in the comment section which of the hairstyles was your favorite and whether or not you plan on trying any of these out. If you're new to my channel, of course, make sure to subscribe, click that notification bell, then you'll never miss any future uploads. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.